Thank you for watching the Namibian Community in the USA Eye Report. My name is Valentina-Rachel Nghiwete, reporting from Washington, D.C. in the USA. On March 21st, 2015, Namibia celebrated its 25th independence from apartheid South Africa. Namibians and Friends of Namibia in the USA celebrated their independence with two official functions. One was organized by the Namibian UN mission in New York City, and the other event was organized by the Namibian Embassy in Washington, D.C. In this video, you will see the actual footage from the Washington, D.C. celebrations, including interviews with Namibians and Friends of Namibia in the USA. You will also see the interview that we had with the Herero Paramount Chief Vekuii, Rukoro, who was visiting the USA in regard to the Herero Nama genocide. At the end of the video, you will see pictures from the New York City celebrations, as well as the pictures from Washington, D.C. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video.
Dr. Shannon Smith, Excellencies, members of the Diplomatic Corps, distinguished invited guests, fellow Namibians, ladies and gentlemen, I'm profoundly honored to welcome you all and thank you for joining us this evening as we celebrate the 25th Independence Anniversary of the Republic of Namibia. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, on March 21st, 1990, Namibia attained her freedom and independence. On that historic day, we achieved our objective of political emancipation and sovereignty, following a protracted bitter struggle for our liberation. It has been 25 years now since Namibia became a free nation, free from the shackles of German occupation, apartheid, and colonialism. The attainment of our freedom and independence was not easy. It was a difficult road that called for gallantry and sacrifice. As we celebrate our independence anniversary tonight, we pay homage to our forefathers, the heroes and heroines of the Namibian soil, who sacrificed their lives in order for Namibia to be free and independent. Their sacrifices have not been in vain. We shall forever remember them for having held the beacon of freedom and liberty high in the face of a long and arduous journey to ensure Namibia's eternal sovereignty, peace, stability, and prosperity. At this juncture, I wish to acknowledge with great appreciation the support rendered by the international community, and in particular the African Union, organizing African Unity at that time, to the people of Namibia during the struggle for our liberation. As my president always put it, Namibia is a product of international solidarity. Namibia has become a model of democracy during its 25 years of independence. We have held regular, free, fair, and peaceful elections as testament to Namibia's stable democracy. Our former president, Vekuii, was awarded the 2014 Mo Ibrahim Prize for African Leadership. The former president received the award because he had demonstrated sound and wise leadership during his tenure as President of the Republic of Namibia. We are proud of his achievement and his exemplary leadership. I also wish to underscore the fact that because of the strong foundation laid by the founding president, Samuel, and consolidated by former President Obama, the ground has been properly set for the current president to continue guarding Namibia's reputation as a well-governed, stable country and inclusive democracy. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, Namibia and the United States of America have excellent bilateral relations. The two countries enjoy long-standing cultural, political, and economic relations. For the past 25 years, Namibia has received tremendous support and assistance from the United States government through various programs led by, among others, United States Agency for International Development, the President's Emergency Plan for AIDS Relief, and the Millennium Challenge Corporation. We are indeed grateful for this generous support and assistance from the US government and the American people. I would like to particularly extend our special thanks to the many US Peace Corps volunteers who have served in Namibia and those who continue to serve in our country. They work tirelessly within our communities in support of our government's education, agriculture, and tourism programs. Deputy Assistant Secretary, distinguished guests, I wish to thank you all once again for joining. joining us in celebrating this special occasion of our Silver Jubilee, and hope that you will enjoy the rest of the evening. It is now my distinct honor to invite you to join me in a toast to the continued excellent bilateral relations between Namibia and the United States of America, and to the good health of our respective President, President Barack Obama and President Hage Geingob, and to the prosperity of our two countries. The President.
A quarter century is definitely worth celebrating. I was in Namibia a few weeks earlier, and the excitement about the upcoming Jubilee and opportunities for the next 25 years was absolutely palpable. Especially as Namibia embarks on the final third of its three pillars which underpin Vision 2030. Peace, which you have done so much for already, stability, which you have achieved, and prosperity, which is still unfolding. The United States and Namibia, as the ambassador said, enjoy a genuine friendship that dates back to Namibia's freedom in 1990. So this Silver Jubilee also heralds 25 years of strong U.S.-Namibian relations. Since 1990, our partnership has flourished just as our countries have thrived. At first, the effort was, of course, the establishment of a new government. And the assistance programs we designed together at that moment reflected that reality. As the years went by, we tackled social and economic development, projects impacting education and health especially. When crises arose, we stood together, as we did when the scourge of HIV/AIDS shocked the world. We continue to partner with one another today as Namibians look to achieve an AIDS-free generation. Most recently, Namibia and the United States completed a compact under the U.S. Millennium Challenge Corporation. Led by Namibians, the initiative was to reduce poverty through economic growth by advancing education, agriculture, and tourism. This compact represented the highest trust between partners, based on confidence in a nation's willingness to make the right choices for its people. All of those projects were led by Namibians to a strong and successful conclusion. So what then is next? While we continue to support critical programs in health and the environment today, at age 25, our relationship has matured into a more robust partnership. We share Namibia's commitment to women's empowerment and peaceful democratic traditions, and we admire your leadership on the continent and well beyond. Together, we can also grow both our economies. I look forward to the day when investors pledge to Namibia, and when Namibia plays a leading role in the region on renewable energies. I also look forward to the day when I can go buy a Namibian steak, a little Safeway, and I hope and understand that day may be very soon. And I started the evening with a window blogger, and hope to see that in our stores as well. Namibia's leadership by example sets a very high standard. As the ambassador noted, the recent awarding of the Mo Ibrahim Prize for African Leadership is a testament to your country's leadership, not only of former President Pamba, but also of the broader commitment to democratic principles by all Namibians. These democratic successes are translating into economic success, because democratic success conveys stability and confidence, tells the world that the rule of law is respected in Namibia. Democratic success tells the world that Namibia is open for business. Visiting Namibia a few weeks ago, I was welcomed with all graciousness and much enthusiasm. I think largely because the rain started about half hour after I landed, continued most of the rest of the time. I hope you feel the same when I bring you snow here tomorrow. But tonight, it is all about independence and liberty, and it is about 25 years of freedom and democracy and progress. And tonight, on this very special day, the United States stands with you as your partner and your friend. We look forward to the next quarter century and to Namibia's achievement of Vision 2030. Thank you so much. Thank you all.
It really was a reflection of Namibia. It was more than him, and it meant that the country is well run, well managed. That the issues of the people, nobody's stealing money. There are no Swiss bank accounts from the government, and so I think it's a reflection of Namibia. And everything that I saw in Namibia, I thought that award was that. I was in Tunisia maybe 3 years ago for the Moses Graham Award, where the Cape Verdean president was. But the last year, they didn't give it to anybody. But they don't give it just to be giving an award. You got to earn it. So I was really thrilled and honored by it. He's a real decent man. Sam and Joe was a real decent man. Hagi Gengop is. And I think the prime minister may have a chance to be the next one. So I think he's going to have a woman after Hagi.
What a wonderful day. It was a wonderful day. Just to tend it off, just to finish it. Celebrating with Namibians, fellow Namibians and friends of Namibia. Happy birthday, Namibia, and God bless Namibia with a new president. We're in great hands.
About our independence. Congratulations, Namibia!
Congratulations, we're very proud of Namibia.
Welcome to America.
Thank you. It's been a very good trip so far. The highlight so far has been the presentation of the petition to the German embassy, where we delivered the petition signed by more than 1,000 Namibians as well as other supporters of our cause, including 35% Germans, people of German origin, who support our cause. Our cause being the demand to pay reparations to the Namibian people, the Hereros and the for the genocide committed by the General Lothar von Trotta against our people as part of the extermination order way back during the 1904-1907 campaign. And it went exceptionally well. And we hope that you will convey this to the German authorities and that they will take this very seriously and extend the necessary apology to the Herero and other people, which will then be followed by then having to set the process in motion to sit down with us, with our leaders, and discuss the modalities that will eventually lead to the process to discuss the whole issue of paying reparations to our people. As you might know, I've been living in Washington for 2 years, way back in the 1980s, as a student. And coming back after so many years, it's absolutely great. Met some old friends as well that I haven't seen for so many years. And the reception by so many Namibians, I didn't realize that we had so many hundreds of Namibians living in the United States after all these years. And it's really been great to receive by them. Such a warm, hospitable people.
They know nothing about Namibia.
I know some Njoma. Yes.
Namibia is a beautiful country and beautiful people. I love it.
We celebrate.
Namibia, land of peace, stability, and prosperity. Let us celebrate together 25 years of independence. One Namibia, one nation.
Oh, prosperity. One Namibia, one nation. Thank you, Safishuna. Sema sanu yoma. Thank you, Tate Ngifike. Punye pohamba. And now we weri. Weri. Weri kamingi. Dogota hage genkop. Peace, stability, oh, prosperity. One Namibia, one nation. Thank you, Safishuna. Sema sanu yoma. Thank you, Tete Ngifike. Punye pohamba. And now we weri. Weri. Weri kamingi. Dogota hage genko. We sele. Sele. We sele. Namibia, land of peace, stability, and prosperity. Let us celebrate together 25 years of independence. One Namibia, one nation. Oh, prosperity. One Namibia, one nation. Thank you, Safishuna. Sema sanu yoma. Thank you, Tate Ngifike. Punye pohamba. And now we weri.
This is 25 years. Oh, prosperity.
One Namibia, one nation. Thank you, Safishuna. Sema sanu yoma. Thank you, Tete Ngifike. Punye pohamba. And
Nairobi kuna kwetu kufami kuna tate po hamba go hamba what you ninga hey hamba tate hake oh make we tele we tele bele kwetu mwe anya saba na mipi anga step kanya kukwe tate hako mbojo no make tate hake tate karunga de kuyambeke tato veta ogo singori ya suku no mwe.
Oh, prosperity, one Namibia, one nation. Thank you, Safishuna. Sema sanu yoma. Thank you, Tate Ngifike. Unye pohamba. And now we waiting. Waiting. Waiting coming. Yogota hage genko. We sell it.
Their blood waters our freedom, tribute to all our heroes, one Namibia, one nation. So me a sing, it's a new beginning, new era. My president is Hage, no error. I see changes as we go further, and that starts with the man in the mirror. So we patiently wait on President again to deliver on prosperity. With disciplined youth, we pledge our support. Sinner to teen, we are the future.
It's peace when you vibe, yeah. Peace, stability, oh, prosperity. One Namibia, one nation. Thank you, Safishuna. Sema sanu yoma. Thank you, Tate Ngifike. Unye pohamba. And now we waiting. Waiting. Waiting coming. Dogota hage genkofi.